Oh. I can hear something rattling in there. This has to look hilarious. In any case... Did we break something off? Hey there, fellows. I suggest we do a recap of the stuff that we've done to these automobiles. Specifically in terms of suspension and wheel mods. You might remember how we made those eccentric wheels, the ones with the offset centerpieces. We welded pipe into the suspension. I essentially drove around with no suspension at all. On pipes while my spine was crumbling out onto the seat. And now a new idea has occurred to us. It's been a while since we've tried something weird. And so here's what we've cooked up for this one. So look here. Yesterday, we went to a scrap metal yard with the intention of acquiring these lovely and mighty springs. Let me explain the idea. You see, regular car springs are too weak for what we have in mind, but these are nice and strong, so they're just what we need. Just what the doctor ordered. As for what we're doing, well, these are going to be replacing the suspension. Now, they're designed to be compressed, right? But we want to mount them in such a way as for them to bend. So we take a wheel, fit a spring to it, we weld it up, and on this end we weld on a sort of flange that we'll bolt to the wheel hub. And from there, the bending of the springs is going to act as the car's suspension. They'll bend and provide a suspension effect. Now this is going to be a really interesting one. So let's make us that kind of suspension and try it out. Let's do this. Fellas, big thanks for taking so many pictures with our merch. You want some drip like this for yourself? Then check out our latest collection of merch. We've got some trendy hoodies, some toasty vests, stylish hats and t-shirts, baseball caps to suit anybody's taste, mugs, stickers, and of course some goodies for your cars. Air fresheners, license plate frames, document holders, key fobs. Hit the link in the description to get yourself some Garage 54 goodness. Get yourself some merch and don't forget to use the code Garage 54, which is good for a solid discount. Sprung wheels for 107% comfort in a Lada, translation and voiceover by BMI Russian. Alright, fellas, this is looking very good indeed. We've welded the springs to the wheel hubs and to the rims. Here I am turning the steering wheel. We, of course, had to hack the guards up to increase the steering angle. And all in all, it seems to be holding up. Yeah, awesome. Well, and I expect it to keep holding up. Right, maybe if I stand right here... Yeah, they work. Nice. Is the suspension articulating, though? Okay, now I see. Guys, wait! That's enough for me to get the picture. Right, so that would be the... stock suspension articulating. No worries. Here is what we're gonna do. We'll put some springs in the back. And then I'm gonna roll out on this type of setup. We're gonna let all of the springs do their part. I'll drive the car as is for the time being. And then we'll figure it out from there. Alright, here's what's interesting here, fellas. The springs we had were long and thin, and after lowering the car on them, here's what we're looking at. The rear axle is on the floor. Now that can't be good. Now I thought it'd work beautifully on this sort of length. But hey, I mean, no use getting upset, right? We just need to shorten these springs. But not by cutting the springs themselves, but rather by welding in some metal support. By means of securing a certain portion of the springs, while the free section is going to have to continue contorting. They're a bit soft. I can hear something rattling in there. This has to look hilarious. In any case, did we break something off? Right, let's shorten the spring. This won't do, I mean, the car has to be able to drive. We didn't do all of this for nothing. We have to make this work somehow. Right then, shorten the springs, lower the car, and see where things go from there. Okay, we doing this? Here's where we're at with this, fellows. Even after welding in the braces to support the spring, it's still way too soft. And that's a bummer. The car just falls onto its rear axle, rendering it unfit for use. And so, we had to go shopping. Here's the spring that we used, and this is what I was able to source. I had to pluck these from a tractor. Now that thing sits on rollers, and this is the kind of spring they use for those. The bar itself is much thicker on these, and as a result it's much stiffer. They're hard to bend even using a crowbar. Right, let's hack these springs off then, and instead weld on these bad boys. Hopefully they can hold their own. Alright, let's get to mounting them. Alright, so these tractor springs have... Yeah. It's nice to drive around with a panhard rod, but hey, at least it's all nice and stiff. The brake drum dust guard has plenty of clearance. I'm assuming it's durable enough to not fall apart right here, right now. I think we need to start the car and go for a drive. For the time being, we will be running the stock Lada suspension, even though it is missing a link, but that's okay. So the stock springs will be doing their thing. Now I'm expecting this to be supremely comfortable. Let's find out, shall we? Right, I'm in position. This will definitely take up more space on the road with such a wide stance. How do I even drive away from the lift? Oh wow, the steering is all over the place. That's what you get with such a wide track. What do I expect from the handling? The steering most definitely won't be sharp, with how the wheels are most likely going to be wobbling. Yeah, something tells me we're not going to be driving fast at all. But hey, it's going to drive how it's going to drive. And now I have a passenger. And another one!
You worried we'll break it?
Well, I'm not sure about that, but this'll definitely be a good test. Wow, that's nice and soft. If only the steering wheel weren't so unruly. Now, we're not gonna make it through there. Look at how it's working the bumps. The rear end is especially supple. As for the front, well, that... What's up? We good? That leaves a bit to be desired. Honestly, guys, steering this thing while driving over the bumps is pretty unpleasant. With the wheels being so far apart, They're trying to tear the steering wheel from your grip. That's something I can feel very well. If, say, the left wheel were to hit a pothole, the car would veer to the left. And if it's the right wheel, it's gonna go to the right. Which isn't ideal. But man, is this thing comfortable! Holy cow! For a Lada to be this smooth and soft and smooth, soft, supple, yeah. I'm steering with the pedals at this point. I would go faster, but there are just so many cars that I'm afraid to. If something were to break, there is no telling which way the wheels are gonna fly. I can barely hold on to it. I'm assuming you can see that. And that's a serious drawback. That was me letting it go. I'd better not do that anymore. What can I say? I've taken a ride on the stock suspension in the spring wheels, and it's quite a nice thing to drive. It's very nice and supple. Now we weld up the factory suspension, so that it stays in place. And after that we drive around just on the spring wheels. Alright, so look here. Everything is looking good. We've welded in some rods to keep the stock springs from articulating. Now it's just the wheel springs working. And look at them go, I mean. It's the same exact story in the back. The suspension is fixed in place. These lovely wheel springs are the only cushioning we have now. Now it's time for us to test them and see how well they work. You said this would be stiff? Well, yeah, the ride is definitely harsher, but it's not the same as driving on metal pipes. Remember how we did that and had no movement in the suspension? When it wasn't doing any sort of dampening. We'll be alright. Everything's alright as long as you have a good grip on the steering wheel. You need to keep hold of it. Well, it has become a lot shakier. But it's still quite soft. Well, I mean, I wouldn't say it's perfect. It's definitely not as good as the regular suspension on a car. But it is doing something. I mean, at the very least, not all of the bumps are making it through to the seat. Which is good. Oh, there we are. Our favorite road. It's a great place to test a car. Oh yeah, it has gotten considerably stiffer. Don't be afraid, dude. Oh, step on the gas already. We're also scared. There we go. Well, what can I even say? It works, but it ain't 107%. I was expecting this to be way softer. Now, it's not ripping the wheel from my grip. Yeah, you know what? After trapping the factory suspension, it's not as unruly as it was before. I can somewhat easily maintain a grip on it. With the stock springs working, you could barely hold on. But now, well, it's at least somewhat manageable. Right now we're coming up to a nice little jump. We can use it for some testing. Oncoming car. What do I... stop, I guess? Or are we clear? Yeah, it jumps around when you let go of the wheel. I mean, obviously, whichever wheel hits a bump, that's the direction it's going to take a hop in. And here we have a bunch of them. Which way is it gonna go? Not into the garages. What is happening? Right, left. What was that? Is it caught on something? Right, the wheel got snagged. You people scared? Honestly, this was a ton of fun. I mean, it bears some semblance to a working suspension. But the way it works is just fundamentally wrong. The tuning is obviously off. The stiffness. The alignment and all of that. But hey, you can at least drive it. Oh, so that's how it is, huh? Thank you very much. Now, who forgot to install the shocks? Where'd the shocks on this freaking thing go? Honestly, though... Okay, so we've just been out for a drive on this suspension, and it was quite a lot of fun. Now, as you can see... Well, I mean, it does work. It goes up and down. But it also makes a lot of weird movements. And it shakes you up real good. That really gave my insides a shaking. It's as if we were driving with no suspension whatsoever. But if we were to free up the factory suspension, that would make for a wonderful experience. It'd be so nice and supple. I thoroughly enjoyed it. But there was a drawback, in that you had to have a really firm grip on the steering wheel, with how it's being ripped from your hands all the time. Because when a wheel hits a pothole, first it dips, and then it slingshots into the opposite direction. Meanwhile, the steering wheel is doing this the entire way. And on the deeper potholes, it can get especially sketchy. You can probably shoot into a wall or a garage, or into somebody's car. Overall, I'd say we are looking at a 107% success rate here. This type of suspension actually works. Though it's not gonna allow you to go very fast. I mean, who even knows what it might do at a higher speed? Even a tiny bump, I reckon, could send you careening off the road, or even result in the car flipping. And so there you have it. It's a nifty idea. I recommend you try it if you have some kind of beater car that you're willing to sacrifice. And of course, some heavy-duty springs. That was a lot of fun and a really interesting experiment. Well, and that's all I have for you. Watch us, subscribe, suggestions, comments, give us a big thumbs up. All right, catch you later.